Here I want to discuss multiple reactions and selectivity. So in most situations, more than one reaction takes place in a chemical reactor. And so selectivity can be more important than rate of reaction, namely how much the desired reaction takes place compared to the undesired reaction. So I'm looking at two reactions in parallel, where this is our desired reaction, but we also have a second undesired reaction. I'm going to talk about selectivity. Typical way of defining it, though this is not unique, is the rate of formation of our desired product, the rate this first reaction occurs, divided by the rate of formation of all products, namely the rate the first reaction plus the second reaction occurs. This is often multiplied by 100 to make selectivity the percentage. But the idea is that selectivity is important in a chemical reactor and can dominate how we carry out the reaction. And so what we want to look at is how it's affected by things like concentration and temperature and type of reactor. So the typical way then we might write selectivity in symbols for this system of parallel reactions is the flow rate at the exit of our desired product over the flow rate of desired plus the flow rate of the undesired. So these are moles per time for, say, a plug flow reactor. We could also define selectivity, say, for a batch reactor, the number of moles of D in the reactor at any given time over the number of moles of D plus the number of moles of U for these parallel reactions. Let's discuss how concentration affects selectivity. Higher concentration favors higher order reaction. Again, looking at these two parallel reactions, if our desired reaction is second order, so this is the rate constant of concentration squared, and one desired reaction is first order, then if we want a higher selectivity, we want to carry out the reaction at high concentrations of our reactant. And there's various ways we can do this, such as increasing the pressure in a gas phase reaction, changing the type of reactor we use. But higher concentration favors this higher order reaction. Next variable I'll look at is temperature, because temperature also has a large effect on selectivity. Higher temperature favors the reaction with the higher activation energy. So again, two parallel reactions. The activation energy, I'm just looking at now at the rate constant, the pre-exponential factor, and an exponential term for the activation energy. So the activation energy is going to be proportional to the slope on this rate versus 1 over temperature diagram. So in this diagram, as we raise the temperature, as we go to the left, raise the temperature, then the rate increases. It increases exponentially. So I'm plotting the log of the rate versus inverse temperature, a straight line. The desired reaction slope and absolute value, since the slope is minus the activation energy divided by R. Desired reaction activation energy is higher, therefore its absolute value of slope is higher. So our desired reaction means that as I raise the temperature, so this is higher temperature at this end, then the desired reaction rate is higher than the undesired reaction at this higher temperature. At lower temperatures, the rates would be equal or even less, the rate constants. And so if we want to have a high selectivity for our desired reaction, we want to run the reaction at higher temperatures. Now, other things may occur as we do this, so we have to be aware of them. Additional reactions might take place, energy demand of higher temperatures, multiple things that we would have to worry about. The type of reactor also influences selectivity, and influences it because of the concentration. As I indicated earlier, higher concentrations then favor reactions that have the higher order of reaction. So batch, tubular, or plug flow reactors have a high concentration of reactant inlet and that concentration decreases with time, CSTR, we immediately drop to our final concentration. So if we want to favor this reaction with a higher order, we should run in a batch or a plug flow reactor to get that reaction preferentially taking place at the higher concentration. If we wanted to favor instead this reaction, then we're better off running in a CSTR to get higher selectivity for the second reaction. And then the semi-batch reactor gives us additional control. So you can imagine, and in that case, we want to look at, for example, A plus B reacting in parallel reaction to desired and undesired products. And let's say R also. So here, let's look at order of reaction. So the rate of this first reaction, the rate of desired products, so rate constant, and let's say it's second order in B, whereas the undesired, let's say it's first order in A and B. So I want the concentration of B to be high. I might run the reaction by starting with B and then adding A to keep the concentration of B high. And by carrying out the reaction in a semi-batch reactor this way, I'm going to favor the desired reaction because the concentration of B is going to stay as high as possible for this type system.